you haven't been subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now. Thank you so much guys for watching and see you on my next video. As you can see, and I think that is your favorite jersey in my career. So if you have already played previous versions, you can play like that in my career. So almost the same guys. But before that guys, you must receive this kind of email from the management. It says, now that you're firmly established in the starting lineup, we'd like to give you the opportunity to provide input on what jersey is.
Luffy's Gear 5 is finally here. So I tried the new One Piece Gachapon game machine, which rewards you with real life One Piece items. And it's actually the only one that exists in the whole world. But strangely, this game is not located at the Jump Shop, nor at the official One Piece store. Instead, you'll need to go meet Pac-Man at the Namco Arcade Center at Kabukicho Tower to join Luffy and the rest of the Straw Hat Pirates on this adventure. It costs 500 yen to power to join Luffy and the... Instead, you'll need to go meet Pac-Man is not located at the Jump Shop, nor at the official One Piece store. Instead, you'll need to go meet Pac-Man at the Namco Arcade Center at Kabukicho Tower to join Luffy and the rest of the Straw Hat Pirates on this adventure. It costs 500 yen to play, but trust me, it's worth it. As soon as the game starts, you'll get some lore, and you'll get instructions on how to play the game, and more importantly, how to win a Devil Fruit with the prize inside. First, Luffy will beat you up for no reason, and then will come say hi like nothing happened. Then, Adio will ask for your help, so you'll spin the helm to the left, and what a surprise, he tricked us. But it's okay, because Sanji will start kicking you and tell you to spin to the left again. And the green Devil Fruit will show on the screen, and it will magically become a real Devil Fruit. You will need to build the Devil Fruit up, and inside you'll find one of these four characters. And I got the worst one because it got Lim. Luffy's Gear 5 is finally here. So I tried the new One Piece Gachapon game machine, which rewards you with real-life One Piece items. And it's actually the only one that exists in the whole world. But strangely, this game is not located at the Jump Shop, nor at the official One Piece store. Instead, you'll need to go meet Pac-Man at the Namco Arcade Center at Kabukicho Tower to join Luffy and the rest of the Straw Hat Pirates on this adventure. It costs 500 yen to play, but trust me, it's worth it. As soon as the game starts, you'll get some lore, and you'll get instructions on how to play the game, and more importantly, how to win a Devil Fruit with the prize inside. First, Luffy will beat you up for no reason, and then will come say hi like nothing happened. Then, Adio will ask for your help, so you'll spin the helm to the left, and what a surprise, he tricked us. But it's okay, because Sanji will start kicking you and tell you to spin to the left again. And the green Devil Fruit will show on the screen, and it will magically become a real Devil Fruit. You will need to build the Devil Fruit up, and inside you'll find one of these four characters. And I got the worst one because I got Lim. Luffy's Gear 5 is finally here. So I tried the new One Piece Gachapon game machine, which rewards you with real-life One Piece items. And it's actually the only one that exists in the whole world. But strangely, this game is not located at the Jump Shop, nor at the official One Piece store. Instead, you'll need to go meet Pac-Man at the Namco Arcade Center at Kabukicho Tower to join Luffy and the rest of the Straw Hat Pirates on this adventure. It costs 500 yen to play, but trust me, it's worth it. As soon as the game starts, you'll get some lore, and you'll get instructions on how to play the game, and more importantly, how to win a Devil Fruit with the prize inside. First, Luffy will beat you up for no reason, and then will come say hi like nothing happened. Then, Adio will ask for your help, so you spin the helm to the left, and what a surprise, he tricked him. But it's okay.
Great. No.
Sanji will start kicking you and tell you to spin to the left again.
Yeah, she's just trying to protect me, man. That's all. Right. Well, make sure to let her know that I was clear with you that this is an off the records interview.
Bro, it sounds like she put the fear in your heart a little bit.
Yeah, well, she knows a lot about my personal life. I'll just leave it at that.
Okay. Anyway. Interesting, but we can leave it at that.
Anyway. What I know so far is that Othella Akpem has been butting heads with people in the front office.
Yeah.
Is this correct?
Is true?
Can you tell more about
that? That's what I'm here for, man. But I do have to ask you, I'm a little nervous right now. I usually do things like this, so just help me a little bit.
I promise to be a sympathetic, yet journalistically impartial.
Great, I appreciate that. So as you know, it all starts on draft night, and most of the fans didn't want me there.
I remember.
Yeah, so they hired Freddie Novak to smooth things over with the fans from a PR perspective.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. But it wasn't like a commercial, like, cynical stuff like the media made it out to be.
What was it?
Okay, so they wanted to ease my transition to the starting lineup. So if the fans were all over me, any little mistake I made would be a huge deal in the press. You know what I'm saying? So the front office just wanted to take the pressure off. It was all about helping me reach my highest potential.
So this was a top-down initiative?
Oh, absolutely. But the thing is, I was also on board with it. You know, supporting the community has always been huge for me, so I was already planning to get to know the fans regardless.
I see. Now, you're right. But how did Othello Akpem then play into this?
He couldn't even get on board with that. The entire organization had approved of this plan, and not one person disagreed with it other than Othello.
And you know this for a fact.
Hey, John, you can do it again if you want. But he made it very clear that he didn't want me doing anything besides me. I mean, which is very wild, because even if the whole drafting didn't happen, isn't it best practice to have a good relationship with the fans?
Wow, okay, so why do you think he was so against him having these interactions with the fans?
And you can open the can by just giving it a good squeeze. If your can opener has broken and you're trying to open a can which hasn't got a wrinkle on, you could actually open it in an emergency by rubbing the seam at the top over the top of some sandpaper. Keep sanding and sanding until you open the seam and can see the individual layers. The lid of the can and the sides are no longer wrapped around each other. Wipe off any dust. And you can open the can by just giving it a good squeeze. If your can opener has broke,
let's make a rockin' breakfast. We're gonna start by getting our breakfast sauces down in the pan. We put it on the heat, and while it starts cooking, we're gonna make our French toast pull apart. So I got eggs, milk, a little vanilla, and some cinnamon. That's my mix. Stir it up really well. Get your bread. I'm gonna go ahead and cut this into little pieces, just
hey,
like
the
baby food tongs.
I'm not sure, but it was not reasonable. I mean, there was no logical explanation for it. So all I could think of is that he had some sort of accident or something.
But with who?
I don't know. I have no clue. Was it me, Freddy, the fans? I mean, he didn't say it, obviously, but I don't know.
When that egg is ready,
that's very interesting.
Yeah, I thought you might like that.
Well, of course, I'll have to verify all this. I mean, I can't publish these claims based on one off-the-record interview.
No, listen, man, I expect nothing less than that. I understand.
Okay, well, is there anything else I should do?
No,
I mean, look, I don't know what your motivation behind doing this, Lord. Did I ask? But I appreciate you coming to me with this story.
I appreciate you, man, taking the time as always.
Anytime you want to talk again about this, let me know. I'm always here.
Colossus.
Genius. Okay. Oh, she's skinning. Jesus. crust you. So what do you do then? You cut off three bits of metal, you stuff them in. Who would think of that, though? Haven't you got them, like, wall plugs that you usually work?
How to get an afro in 2K23.
How to do the Spring of Darkness tattoos. Buy these tattoos.
Yeah, I forgot I can just go to a barber shop. Hopefully I got a barber shop. Dogs.
Go over to the appearance section, click on the head. You go to your hair, and when you select your hair, just edit the hair and the hair color right there. And here's all the hair colors. Your hair, just edit the head. You click appearance. Go over to the appearance section. Click the head.
So is a man cheating you? Why is a brown supposed to be black?
I'm a left back seat. And I'm not the one, but don't forget to get me. I could buy you stuff. I'm going to buy you stuff. Stop. Stop.
So the Pelicans win the tip. You know, the first thing you think of with both these teams, Greg, their athleticism. Some high flyers on the court tonight.
And Kev, it's not just about the aerial skills, though. There are some guys out there who can flat out wear you down with their ability to run the floor.
And it's Daniels with the rebound. McCollum with the ball. Kicks it to Daniels. Too long in the paint. He's hit with a 3-second violation. One falls for Ingram.
Well, there's been some interesting moves in the Bayou, and this team has set up a roster that I think has some great potential. There's a lot of talent, a lot of interesting players that are on this roster, and I'm excited for their future.
Williamson left side. All sorts of time. Rebound by the Bulls. It's time now to hear from our Hall of Fame reporter, David Aldridge. What's the latest, David?
It's a foul. He holds it. Z. Williams. Zach Williams. That's a foul. Why he holding it? Actually doing to
see where their energy lies throughout this game.
All right, thank you, David. Real good, MP. You definitely saw New Orleans making calculated moves, Brent, in the draft.
Yeah, there's some perfect fits alongside what a healthy Zion Williamson will bring to the court. And so if he's in there making that impact, there's a lot of complementary skill sets on this roster that will elevate them to being much more competitive sooner than you think.
To the paint. Here's Williamson. Makes it off the glass.
The closer that Zion is going to get, the more effective he's going to
Zion.
Become.
Zion.
So it's bring it up to the Bulls. Getting their first of the season at this Pelicans team.
And this was as even a matchup as you'll find in the NBA. Split the season series down the middle. One apiece.
Very difficult to imagine. It'll be much different this season.
Keeping up there, Bob.
Short spaces, Bob. Get me up there, Bob. I need you to get me up there, Bob.
And that one falls for Ingram.
And you look at the way when he gets to his spots, there's just no stopping him. Very few players can create like he can.
First 1:30 gone here in the first quarter. And there's the defensive 3-second call.
Zion is calling you to a higher place, to a higher place of grace. That's my favorite.
He shows the focus there, nails the technical.
Ingram just continuing to impress and taking strides in the right direction. Just a tremendous amount of offensive weaponry.
First quarter, about a minute and a half in. Alan Junis finds Williamson. That one drops for him.
Setting the tone with an aggressive move to drag and where's the help defensively.
And APB says
he's calling me to hurry up right away.
Try to get an assist on every bucket.
Here's Williamson. Off the glass.
That basket must be winding out right now. He's almost every shot he's putting up.
So when you're up against Vucevic, his soft touch helps him convert inside.
The stage all to himself there, just tearing down the rim.
And great camera work showing up on the AT&T 5G Slam King. And so it's DeRozan who'll bring it up for the Bulls. 7-point differential. Here's Ellison. That one drops and he's now 2-for-5.
Another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively here.
Here's Williamson. That one, no good. And Chicago the other way. This game coming on the heels of their win against Toronto.
Yeah, they were aggressive, but also efficient. Exactly.
No.
Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Still very early in the season here, but teams, Greg, beginning to hit their stride and get into a rhythm.
And the same can be said for the younger talent. The rookies are shaking off those debut jitters and starting to show us what they can really do.
Dragic kicks to Caruso. Back to Dragic. Drummond sets the screen for Dragic. And Andre Drummond, the bucket on the assist from Dragic.
Now, some guys have a hard time finding their teammates in those possessions. Dragic is always looking the dish to get it to the open man.
Now, here's Marshall, defended by Caruso. Now the pass to Murphy, shoots the three. Andre Drummond grabs the miss. Chicago trailing here. Great, their offensive approach has been rock solid here.
And they're finding the weak spots in the D and attacking
them.
Now here's Williams. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Here's Drummond. And that won't go, missing the go-ahead button. The Pelicans have gotten 5 of 10 shots to drop in this game so far. Right at the 50% mark. Here's Hernan Gomez. Finish off by Hernan Gomez.
For the young Spaniard, Hernan Gomez, a good finisher around the basket.
And here's Dragic. Takes the three. No good on the last second attempt there. And so, guys, it's Zion Williamson making things happen for New Orleans. He got into double digits for the quarter with 10 points total. We've got more in store for you right after this.
No, Curry! That's good.
Dad.
MP's checked in for Pelicans, and it's Kobe White in for those two. Zion Williamson's checked in for the Pelicans.
But we got no spoons. Huh? I need to wash the spoons.
Now that miss might stick with him for a little while. That's kind of a shoot-around jumper if I've ever seen one.
The win set for him, Levine and DeRozan. Vucevic is out there with MP, and it's White at the rock. So that's the 5 in the game for Chicago.
Well, White has quickly developed a great forward vision. Doesn't miss the wide open man. What you love about Vucevic, the consistency, solid shooting percentages, and he's averaged double-digit rebounds for the last 5 years.
And now the latest from our reporter, David Ulmer.
Thanks, Kevin. Last season, we know the Pelicans were trying to bring in CJ McCollum.
No. Move.
Season, tough thing to do, but he is a veteran that can certainly handle it. Ball in his hands, good things usually happen. Hey, David, thank you for that story.
Have you stopped trying to throw stuff at me?
The game is on the board with that shot made. Yogurt adding to that for Vucevic. For his 2 seasons, he's been excellent in the playoffs.
Great point. He is clutch shots, gives him a physical presence.
Pelicans leading by 3. And for those of you just joining us in the second quarter, with about 3 minutes gone by, drains it from beyond the arc.
That's just a lapse right there. But somebody has to be there and get a hand up in the shooter's face.
Sam's Dingram. Back to Caruso. Bulls moving the ball around. Five on the clock. Here's Ellison. And the Bulls with another miss. And so Marshall will bring it up for the New Orleans Pelicans. 6-point lead. They'll be playing host to Portland for their next game. And it's Ingram missing.
I saw a green light there. He's not going to get away with that kind of lapse all that often here tonight.
White dishes to MP. White the pass to Ellison. Good. Score of the basket. Mark him 4-for-8. Shooting 50% so far.
And those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten here in the first half.
Mr. Williamson. And it's a defensive 3-second violation. And so he hits the technical free throw. And what makes changes for Chicago. Patrick Williams, he's checked in for Vucevic. Javonte Green comes in for Levine. And it's Dragic in for Kobe White.
That's just enough defensive pressure on him to draw off that shot. I bet he gets a good look at it next time and hits it.
To the inside. Here's Ellison. Herman Gomez grabs the miss. Pelicans lead by 5. For 3, Ingram. Rebound by Williams.
If he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
And that's going to be a turnover. They call him for 8 seconds.
Okay, we got what? Kyrie, you can have it, but when I need it, it will give it back. You own 1% chance, 1-1-0-0-0.
What?
Welcome. The first half is in the books, so let's check out the top performers for each team.
A couple of guys locking horns tonight. Neither one of them backing down as you would expect. You could tell both teams are giving these guys space to work.
And they're taking advantage of the opportunity. And we come back to the game at hand in the first half. Plenty to like for the Pelicans.
I'll guarantee you something right now. They wouldn't be legal without their roof. Let's take them off and fire.
I don't know if that's a guarantee or if it's
Anyway,
enjoyed the broadcast so far. We're halfway through the game. Zion Williamson with a strong contribution so far, guys, in this one.
Early on, he has been feasting in the paint, and you have to think they're going to keep feeding the big fella.
Oh, man, pouring it on right now, and why wouldn't you?
They're going to turn it over. They couldn't get it inbounds that time. Tanya Chalk to the great ball handlers, and they say, Greg, that footwork is an underappreciated aspect of it. Why is that?
It's like a dance. You're eluding the defender mostly with your feet.
Setting the floor now for the Pelicans. Ingram in the front court with Williamson. Then there's Jonas Valanciunas. Then there's McCollum. And it's Daniels in at the two guard. McCollum kicks to Ingram. And so it's going to be a 3-second violation out there on the defense. Is good. Unfortunately, the Pelicans did make a first-round exit in the postseason group.
In a series they took to 6 games, but yeah, they couldn't put together that deep run. Maybe this year things will be different.
And there's the 3-second call. This one on the defense.
His commitment to this young quarterback.
No, with the guys, why is
Josh added to their bevy of young
leaders.
They're building.
Put your hands on my ball.
Take it. Move. Why that's coming? Move. I am here.
Here's Dozer move. The shot's good. Checking some stats on him right now. He's averaging just around 22 and a half points a game. To the middle, here's Williamson. That ball, nice feed that time from McCollum. Williamson's got the lead up to 11 now for the Pelicans. Passes it to Dosun. Outside, Levine. Vucevic setting the pick for Levine. Here's Ellison, and he finishes nicely on the way. 12 points for MP.
Yeah, and with improving court awareness, nobody continues to tap into his limitless potential when making plays.
And so it's going to be a 3-second violation of Pelican Court.
Oh!
And so he hits the technical free throw. And Levine's efficient as well.
And good shooting numbers, no doubt. Last year he cut back on the turnovers. And boy, he's still young. There's still tons of upside to be had.
Here's Daniels.
Take it back.
Pass to McCollum. Too long in the paint. He's hit with a 3-second move.
Stop it!
minutes, 3 to shoot, and it's a defensive 3-second violation.
3-second violation.
Go, get it!
We got the last one, Kyrie, didn't it? That should work.
What?
I will dance, I will dance, I will sing.
Behind my tail.
Third quarter of play, we just over a
minute.
Behind me, so I will dance. I will be
and it's Daniels with the rebound.
I will dance, I will sing and be crazy for my kid.
So great to see Zion out on the wing and coming down the lane. That's a guy hard to stop on a fast break. And that last look brought to you by the 5G Swamp Team.
KK!
But go in front of him!
KK, what happened to you?
Don't go in front of him.
What happened to you?
You know, guys.
Ah! By the way! Watch out!
No, 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 no.
Woo! Woo!
Now you're him.
Hey, hey, hey. I'm going. I'm going. Why do
we? Hey, your boy Joey.
It's Murphy.
Na 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 na.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today. We get going in quarter number four. We've got and it's coming in at the pivot spot, man in the middle. So that's the five. Now here's the match. He's going closely. And the game's commercial.
This afro.
To the way right side. And so he hits the technical free throw.
I will dance, I will sing, and be crazy for.
Yo.
Launches a three. Ellison with the rebound. Ellison's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
It's not his best night from the field, but looking for other ways and finding them so he can chip in. How about that shot? Not exactly something drawn up by the coaching staff.
Oh.
McCollum kicks to Daniels. And there's the 3 second call. This one.
And
the technical free throw is good.
Well, he's putting his game right in the face of the defense right now and just driving into the paint to get contact.
Just under 2.5 minutes going.
It's
a defensive 3 second violation.
They suck. Bill Kid sucks. No wonder they didn't make it to the playoffs because they suck. Man, I hate doing that.
And so he hits the technical free throw.
Perfect.
We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. McCollum deciding where to go with it. Pocket 4.
Oh my God.
Shoots over to Consumer. And again, no good by New Orleans. End zone. And he will bring it up for Chicago. Take trail by 18. Murphy with the steal. Here's McCollum inside. Here's Daniels. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum. McCollum.
Effort.
Fudge, man.
Okay.
Oh, but.
Yeah, let's go. And let's fight the champion.
Hey, boom. Oh, he's so mad.
Fourth quarter keeps moving right along. 3 minutes gone so far. Kicks it to MP.
Next shot. No!
Nice touch by MP.
Come on, Dodos. That was almost a dot.
Pelicans leading by 20. McCollum with the ball. Pass to Daniel. And so it's going to be a 3 second by New Orleans. As a line for the Philadelphia, Trey Murphy shooting one.
Some of that looked before cool.
Connect with the history of the game. And the technical free throw is good. And so we see the Pelicans taking the W here to come in Unum.
How did that terminate great? Let's go this shit, bro.
So what's up?
So the trade rumor leaked, and Othella is escalating things.
Okay, because of the Luck article?
Almost certainly. Mm-hmm.
So what's our next move?
Well, first things first, you want him in the press room. Now, Nate might have his report, so you're going to want to call on him first, face this head on.
Okay, yeah.
I'm sure you can. After that, head to the office so we can talk next steps, okay? We're going to have to accelerate the plan a little bit because the rumor dropped.
Yeah, okay. Sounds good.
Remember, you want to be here. You have nothing to hide.
Mm-hmm.
If the team is looking to trade you, this is the first you're hearing about it.
What? Okay.
Yeah.
How do you want to do that, Kyrie? Kyrie, do this. Man, what's Shep Owen say, but I'm slapping. Yeah, man, I always got something to say.
Hey, come on, let's go, let's go, let's go.
Yo, we got some real corn bogs in the league.
Let's go back. Come on. I want to turn to school, come on.
Mama!
Better not be cussing.
SpongeBob!
Kyle, you better not be cussing.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, can you make the car please? Is the car please? Sad. See, now my spin. Oh, that's my fault.
To be the best, and whether I'm here or not, that's what I'm gonna be. The best.
Does that mean you don't mind if you get traded?
Man, I am a big man, guy.
It's news to me. I didn't.
Yeah, well, I am. You know, it helps me stay grounded, and it's a big part of helping me stay in this moment. You know, taking things as they come and not really dwelling on the past or worrying too much about the future. So, truth be told,
I'm really considering. I'm going
to
give it back. I just need
to. Johnny, make a car, take it.
Sure.
Thank you.
I'm glad I'm getting dressed.
No, don't touch that. Doesn't mean touch the controller.
I mean, when you think about it, I kind of
do. Curry is supposed to be.
Let go.
Four key carries.
Okay.
So, bar.
All right, cool. I think I'm done.
Okay.
You guys have a good night.
Cheers. Kisses. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, and this car. Let's go. Oh, why? Papa, let's go. Okay. He made Grandpa a skunk. And I got it.
You are. All right, Kyron, let me use the tablet for a minute.
I got it.
Kyron, I gotta use the tablet.
All right.
I wanna get traded. Now I know the Bulls are crap. They got all these new players and they still don't do nothing.
Kayla, I got my tablet.
Kyron, what'd you do with the phone? Well, Kyron, I need a tablet for me. Kyron, put the bomb on.
All right.
Kyron, just follow this.
Okay.
So, patty.
Patty.
Cheese.
No, not cheese.
All right. How to get traded in 2K23.
How to get traded in 2K23 current gen.
The elevator can be tough for young homeowners turning into their parents.
Maximum weight 1,200 pounds. Good thing I got on before lunch.
Progressive can't save you from becoming your parents, but we can save you money when you bundle home and auto with us.
In today's video, guys, we are going to be learning how to request a trade in NBA 2K My Career Mode. I know there's a lot of videos going around so
I'm doing something.
Request a trade, but honestly, guys, most of them are lying. So I decided, you know
not
what?
Now.
Why not?
Shut up.
Tell you guys how to actually do it. I'm going to teach you guys everything you need to know about
are you tired?
Yeah.
Wide open shots.
Struggling to green even with takeover.
Let's go, babe. Let's go.
Tired of getting laughed at by your friends in the party?
Well, you have come to the right place because today we are going over the Request a trade. You have to complete the game. You basically have to beat the game because once you do the class, there's no more main quest. And in your first season, press the pause to start. So go ahead and press start whenever you're able to. Then you're going to go over to My Career tab. You're going to go to Career Tracker. Once you're there, you'll see on the top of your screen, Request Trade. Now, it's going to say you must play 10 games this season before you can request a trade. So, you're basically going to have to do that. You cannot simulate games.
Okay, all it means is I've got
to. You cannot foul out a game to make them go quicker. What I would recommend for you guys to do. So for faster games, guys, what I recommend you do is take my player, put them on the bench, okay?
At a favorable outcome.
You cannot give yourself less than 24 minutes, so give yourself 24 minutes. Once you put your my player on the bench, go over to your options and your settings and put the core link to 5 minutes. This is going to be able to make you do the quickest possible games. I would also recommend hitting your difficulty on the easiest so that you can simulate with VC. In order to simulate with VC, you have to be winning by 25 or more points in the second half of the game. If you're up by 25 or more points,
pay for in-game advertising, held events with their players. If Bobby's on your side, we'll be ready to move to phase two.
Oh, you mean phase three?
No, phase two.
Phase one was the John Luck interview.
Okay, and Bobby was phase two. So phase three is whatever comes next.
It doesn't matter what phase it is. Just focus on Bobby, all right?
Do you need to go over our plan for him again?
No. You guys, laid it out pretty well for me.
All right, then it's settled. Once we got Bobby in our pocket, we'll launch our final offensive.
Nope.
Sock and all, baby.
No, I told you there. No military references. They don't play well.
You gotta just lighten up, Ashley. Come on.
His name is Jesus. Win over. His name is Jesus. Bye. Name is Jesus.
Awesome, man. I can't thank you enough for what you're doing, by the way.
It's all love, man. It's all love.
Thank you, man. All right, so I am kind of an old school guy, you know, despite the whole... So I was kind of thinking we could hand out some cards and a couple of high-quality locations, you know, so like a good book, you know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Like swags.
Okay.
Pull one up.
Yeah. I can definitely do that.
That would be great.
Yeah. Hey, you have any, like, merchandise or, like, shirts or something?
I got merchandise checking up my hat, man. Yo.
That's tough.
The hat? Dude, I got a great idea, man. Check this out. My own signature hat. You like it? No, come on, man. Hey, look at it. Come on.
Okay, hold on.
All right. That's good. Come on. I'm going to let you go. That's your signature. No. Hey, man. My family's all got one, I got one, and now. Thank you, man. All
right, man. Thanks, Carl.
It's nice, right?
Yeah.
It's good, right?
Let
me just.
Bam. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, dude, that is.
Little picture.
Yeah, man.
Cool.
Yeah, man. Thanks. I really, really appreciate this. Don't forget the, you know, the stacks. I made them myself. And thank you so much, man. Really appreciate it.
Give me an elbow.
Hey, be careful with that, you know. That's a good word. Now.
I got you.
Veganism. All right. You want a hot dog?
No, nah. I'm all right, man. Thank you, though.
Right,
thank you.
Be careful with it.
Yep.
All right.
Shibaba. Shibaba. okay? Shee Baba, hallelujah, Shee Baba, hallelujah, let the enemy be your food, let the enemy be the food. Oh my grandma, let the enemy be rebuked.
See you later, alligator.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, I need more to purchase, bro. How to do the objectives and 2K23 win over Uncle Bobby.
How to do the adjectives and on 2K23 win over Uncle Bobby.
What's up, YouTube? Be really back.
Hey guys, this is just Keith Ellison 80.
Welcome in, welcome in.
stand more. Not at our house.
Have a good day. Take care.
Yo, can y'all hear me? Alright, let me stop. Vocal cords get messed up. Holy night, the stars are brightly shining. That is a birth. That is the birth of our dear Savior's blood. Christmas. You can count on me. Mistletoes as white as snow, and presents under the tree. Christmas, love on Christmas. You can count on me as white as snow and mistletoes and presents under the tree. Christmas, love for Christmas. If only you can.
If only you can.
If only you can count on me. Hallelujah. To God be held. To God be the glory. To Thy be the glory, to Thy, to Thy, to Thy. Be the glory. All the kings. For all the things, all the things He has done. To God be the glory. Hallelujah.
Jesus, we lift your name up high, your name up high. Mm-hmm. 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 All right.
As the Old Testament says long ago, I don't need you to praise him, because I can praise him by myself. Think about Jesus, what he's done for me. What I think about Jesus, how he died on the tree. I can dance all night. I can dance. I can dance all night. Now let me end the stream here, y'all, before I get the Holy Ghost again. Hey! Y'all be safe and God bless.
Y'all be safe and God bless.